the golden rule. So whatever you wish that others would do to you, do also to them, for this is the law and the prophets. Enter by the narrow gate, for the gate is wide and the way is easy that leads to destruction, and those who enter by it are many. For the gate is narrow and the way is hard that leads to life, and those who find it are few. So whatever you wish that others would do for you, do also to them, for this is the law and the prophets. Huh? The first part says, so whatever you wish that others would do to you. This part itself necessitates that we know what we desire. Christ is saying, figure out what is it that you want from others. Figure out firstly what is it that you want. So he's saying, go to the root of your wanting, go to your basic desire. When beneath the clutter of all the superficial desires, you go to the root of desire, you find that your ultimate desire is peace. So from everything, from the entire world, from this and that, from others, from yourself, all you want is peace. Here is a way to peace. Jesus is saying, if you want peace, ensure that you bring peace. Do to others what you want done unto you. You want peace, bring peace to others. You want truth, bring truth to others. You want love, bring love to others. But remember, this can be very easily misinterpreted. To rightly interpret it, first of all, you must know what you really want. This is only for those. Know what you really want and bring it to others as well. The trick here is, you want, let's say, peace. You cannot give peace to others unless you are peaceful. Because peace is not a commodity that you can pull out from your pocket and give to somebody. Peace is an overflowing from your heart. Only when you have it, can you give to others. Jesus is saying, if you want peace, give peace to others. But to give it to others, first of all, you have to have it. So it's a circular thing. You want peace, give peace to others. To give it to others, have an abundance of it. In a sense, he is saying, have what you want. Have what you want. Then, enter by the narrow gate. There are many who enter by the wide gate, but for them there is only destruction, and there are only a few who enter by the narrow gate. The key word here is the broad gate and the many. The narrow gate and the few. Any gate through which a crowd enters is bound to be a gate opening into destruction. Crowd means influence of others on the mind. That's where the crowd exists. What he means is that a mind that is crowded can never enter the truth. A mind that is dominated by many can never enter the truth. Only a mind that is devoted to one can enter the truth. Kabir says, Prem gali ati saatari tame dona samaye. The road of love is so narrow that not even two can walk on it. Only one can walk. The road is so narrow that not even two can walk. Only one can walk. Jesus is saying exactly the same thing here. If you think that you can bring all your friends, family, relatives and their influence on your mind, if you think you can carry all that and still be liberated, still belong to God, it is not possible. You will have to make God your primary relationship. You will have to set truth as your first priority. That is called the narrow road. Narrow because it has space only for the truth. Incidentally, when you are devoted only to the truth, when truth is your first priority, the truth itself takes care of all your other priorities and sets them right. Those priorities that must remain, remain. Those that must fall, fall.